It ain't spec people!
I need to find out which TXV need to be replaced and what units are flat. So they say a leak in this coil somewhere. They say they've been having multiple problems with this unit. People have been trying to repair it, but it always leaks out. So they wanted me to see if I fix the leak, give them a picture of the unit, the micron gauge under 500 micron. But I might put some nitrogen in here and see if it's an obvious leak. But I might just write up, they need to replace this coil. Cause might as well not even play with it. Get a new coil in here. See how the residue. I'm gonna hook some gauges up. See which one is low. These things don't work good sometimes. Definitely low. I'm at 40, 30. That unit probably almost flat. This one here. Okay, this circuit does have refrigerant in it. I'm at 70, 80 PSI. So I think this one got the restriction in it. They said it's a restriction at the TXV, and this unit is flat. Like I said, it's one unit. All right, one unit has a restriction and the other unit is flat. A very low on refrigerant. I think this is the one with
TXV we had to replace. But I'm gonna look around and make sure. I had a recovery machine turned on, but I am, since that recovery tank is under a vacuum, sucking in by itself. But it's not that much refrigerant in there, I don't think. So both circuits has a potential leak. Coils are very damaged. Been numerous attempts to repair this. So, turn this on. So I like to do my cord like that because I don't have to use all of it. So I just string out what I need. This is the TXV kit. If I can get it out of here. They got me two in here. I didn't know that. Thank you. All right, so after further research, I look at the quote. It's written up that we need to change the TXV and circuit one. So this is circuit one. Got it marked right here, circuit one, circuit two. So this is circuit one right here. And unfortunately, we have to change the back TXV. So this one kind of a little bit more harder to get to. So shouldn't be too bad. So I gotta replace this back one. So got all the refrigerant recovered. So here come the fun part. I get set up and start taking these capillary tubes out. Also, like I said once before, if you're getting in this trade and you're a technician, you gotta supervise yourself pretty much. You'll get a number of hours where the job needs to be completed, but like I say, you have to be smart also. So this unit here, it needs to be leak checked, replace the TXVs. So I'm gonna replace the TXV first. Instead of putting nitrogen in there and then leak check and try to find my leak. So I'm, like I said, I'm gonna go ahead and put some, replace the TXV, and then once I put the nitrogen in there to leak check all my welds, I can also be leak checking the unit for this particular spot right here where all this refrigerant residue at. Like I said, I don't know if that refrigerant comes from circuit one or two, but we can find now. Try to take these out straight as possible. Make sure we only taking the ones out that we need.
got three more. I got two more. I probably got something that prop that up. I don't want to bend. I don't want to bend where it's coming out at. I think this is right here. I kind of want to get some to brace this up with. Just to be on the safe side. I don't want this to fall down and bend my pipe. Cause hopefully I can slide the other one right in there. I don't want to pinch them. Thank you. look like we got all on right. All right, well, I got the TXVs out. I'm gonna try to line them up as best I can on the outside. Kind of like how it was. Kink in them. Say this habit somewhere in the vicinity. Of the original one. Easier if I line them up. I got it on the outside. Once you get it in there and try to line them up, you'll reach kinking and put another restriction.
zip ties to give it a little more strength. So once I get ready to put it over in there, I'm gonna be falling everywhere. Like I say, this video probably just gonna be of me installing the TXV, maybe put some nitrogen in it, but we're not gonna charge it up. Might pull it back. See how many we can get in without need something to prop that up. Let's see how many I can get in without soldering. Some of my holes closed up on me. Wrong there. I'm gonna put it up on this one. First one closed up real good on me. Thank you.
hope it don't pop out. I'm gonna purge it with a little nitrogen. Shouldn't take long, but go ahead and run a little bit in there anyway. Go ahead and braise one by one, but I want to just go ahead and get them started. I'm sure they don't pop out on me. Once I get it in there like that, I can kind of work the starter that's already on there. Hopefully it'll hold it. Right there. Probably fly back a little bit. More than one way to skin a cat. There we go. Gonna heat it up a little bit and hold it right there. So hopefully it don't pop out. Saying when I was taking these off, you don't want to bend them in your pipe. At the end of the day, if this pipe was bent, you can always cut it back. Cut the top of back, but slow you down. About 20% on this battery, so I'm gonna get as much as the footage as I can. Never done this before. I think you got the just do of what's going on. You can take it from here. All I'm doing is soldering all this up, soldering this one in, and run some nitrogen through there and do a leak check, leak out. We know we got a leak in the unit, but you can still leak search your wells or your brazed joints with some liquid leak detector. All right, I'm gonna work my way down. Like I say, don't be shy of using too much. Put as much brazing rod as you need. You want to make it look decent, but at the end of the day, it's more important to make sure you don't have any leaks. And make it look pretty. A lot of people try to make it look pretty and end up having a lot of leaks. That's how I was taught anyway. That backside, I like kind of heat up my backside first. Don't take long to heat it up. You know this small copper is soft copper. So you don't want to burn a hole in it. Kind of hard to get to it with this. Whoa, with this short piece. Go ahead and get another stick. it turned green, I know it's ready. For this equalizer line. Be good. Let that. All right, we got 6% on this battery. But I just broke my regulator. That sucks. So it just broke off. Nitrogen bottle fell and broke it. So got to replace that. I think that thing about $50. So we're gonna put some nitrogen in the system and do a leak search on it. So I'm gonna leak search that coil. I'm gonna do my wells first. Make sure I don't have any leaks. Starting off, I'm just gonna put a small amount. I don't want to use all my nitrogen. Hopefully I can leak search both circuits. Still got to replace the filter dryer too. But I want to get out of that cabinet right there, so I'm going to put a little bit in there. Make sure everything closed. Put a small amount in there first. Starting off, kind of listen. See anything thus far. like I said, best to just put a small amount in there. I got 12 PSI, that's good. 12 PSI, when you leak searching, that's okay. When you're doing a pressure test, you want to put a lot in there, like 150, 200 PSI. But if I'm just leak searching my well, because like to use this, remember when you were small, or when kids have the little bubbles that they put in a little bubble thing and blow, you know, if you blow too hard, you're not gonna be able to blow a bubble. But if you blow real soft, you can blow a huge bubble.
I had a copper in my little pot pouch down there, but all I'm doing, I'm gonna braise this up right here. Braise these, let me see, 1, 2, 3, got 4 wells to make, and I'll do another leak search, and we'll call it a day. I'm gonna wrap it up. I'll probably just put like 200 PSI of nitrogen overnight, and I'll come back tomorrow and see if it dropped. But I'm put 200 PSI on both circuits, maybe 300. I think it's worth that to invest that, but I'm gonna put some soap bubbles all around there. If it's a leak that I think I can repair, I will repair it. And then see if we can pull a vacuum. If we can pull it under 500 microns, we'll charge it up. If we can't pull it under 500 microns, I'm gonna recommend replacing that coil. All right, but I'm gonna wrap this video here up. Please like, subscribe. If you feel this can be helpful for anybody that's in HVAC or learning HVAC, please share with them. If you think this is a career that somebody will want to get into, please share it with them. And I appreciate it. Everybody have a good one.
Right here. Right there. See it turning white right there? Like foam right here. All right, I'm gonna make an attempt to try to repair that. And like I say, just pull it back in overnight and see what it'll do. It may be multiple leaks. All right, finally got it where I wanted it.
Try to get back off in there, but that goes to this circuit right here, like I said, and this circuit still had some nitrogen pressure in it, so I kept on getting a little small tiny pinhole, but I think I finally got it. So hopefully that do the trick, but I'm put some nitrogen in it and leak check it again and pull a vacuum overnight and come back in the morning and see what's going on. All right, so what I'm going to do is, I got my vacuum rig set up. I'm pulling a vacuum on each circuit. This is 7 CFM. What's this, yellow jacket, I think. Yeah, two-stage 7 CFM. So it's plenty enough. See how thick the hose is. So it's going to pull a good vacuum. Hopefully we can pull it down to 500 microns. But I'm going to pull it all night, so this probably going to be about 12 hours worth of vacuum, or a little more. And I got my micron gauge up, hooked up. This is the circuit right here. I got it hooked up to the one that I repaired this leak on. I know for a fact I had a leak on that one, and this is the one also. This is circuit one, the one I replaced the TXV on it. But I'm also pulling a vacuum on circuit number two, and I'm suspecting it has a leak also, because I put 170 PSI of nitrogen in that one. And for about 30 minutes, I only dropped to about 169. So hopefully we okay. Maybe the pressure's equalized, I don't know. But if it doesn't pour down to 500 microns by in the morning, we know we got a problem. So I'm still going to recommend replacing the coil. But if it pours down to 500 microns, we can charge it up. Even if one circuit pours down to 500 microns, we can charge at least one circuit up. And it'd be up to them if they want me to go ahead and top the other one off also and wait till we can get a coil in. But that's about it, though. I'm gonna wrap it up. I gotta go down about 3 or 4 flights of stairs and down the elevator. So, but I'm gonna probably monitor for a little while longer. I like to wait until the micron gauge starts counting down. If it starts counting down, I know I at least got a chance. It used to be about 5 or 10 minutes, it'll start pulling to a vacuum. Well, when it starts counting down, I know I got at least a chance of it making it to 500 microns. Like I say, I kind of doubt it, but I'm just hoping it does. Because I know the customer don't want to hear that they need a new coil. But at the end of the day, I'm still going to recommend it. They don't need a new unit. The unit works fine. But like I say, over the years, the coil has been getting too many problems. So, all right, everybody have a good one.